Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman. Plus, I got you a big update on what's going on with this Gulf hurricane that's still forming up. Matter of fact, showing that as it goes earlier, it's going to have an issue with that upper level high transforming from over the Gulf to the eastern side of the Gulf. So as it goes anywhere from the 24th towards the 25th, the 26th, the 27th, and maybe even further for the 28th towards Texas. That's what the Euro actually is seeing. I'm going to show you the latest impacts and the latest trajectory according to all these ensembles and what could more than likely happen. But thank you everyone for helping me alert other people, let them know what is happening with this system, because it's showing either within the next 6 to 7 days, people are going to need to prepare for a possible landfall, maybe a tropical storm. Maybe a hurricane. Now, it did stretch a little further to the west and north. And you can see this. We got the previous outlook and the latest outlook. It did stretch a little bit more towards the west-northwestward, or Euro showing, towards the Gulf of Mexico, towards the center of the Gulf of Mexico. Still showing it's at 20% while it moves next week very slowly as it goes north or northwest over the northwestern Caribbean Sea, or the southeastern Gulf of Mexico still. Now, when you check the update with the Euro, chance for a tropical depression, you see how it still shows the whole system, still goes across the Central American Gyre, but now it's starting to agree on that west-northwest path, and then a curve coming after it. So it's agreeing more like the AI of Euro showed earlier, showing that it is going right towards the center of the Gulf of Mexico. Let's not forget the deep ocean heat content. So as it balls up towards the Western Caribbean, it is going to tap into some deep ocean heat, and it could start intensifying at this moment as it moves on that west or northwest or even north pattern. Latest by GFS shows that as that high pressure meanders over towards the eastern side, that it is going to start coming in with that trough, and it's going to start pulling all this tropical moisture to the western Gulf of Mexico. That could easily take the form of something, so we do need to watch that. That is literally right after 5 days. And as this trough moves further towards the east, it pulls the bulk of it with that trough to the north. Look how it does that. So it starts off towards the northwest. The trough comes down a little bit deeper towards the east, and it kind of goes a little bit further to the north. So it tries to pull all this precipitation, all this tropical moisture to the north, then it goes towards the southeast and it strengthens. But look, that's where it starts pulling it on the GFS. But it starts tugging on it immediately, just like they're seeing with the Euro. So it starts immediately tugging towards the west. And you see where the upper level high is right here. It can't go east at this moment. And then when it pulls to the north, that's because that trough passes by. So it could very easily be right here towards the northern Gulf of Mexico on that vorticity. If it spins up, probably something very weak, it won't have enough time on that vorticity. Or later on, like what GFS is seeing, is still happening towards the northeast. Now, GFS agrees it will go towards the center of the Gulf of Mexico, but it will take a while. It takes 7 days for it to get to the center of the Gulf of Mexico, and the latest run shows it could turn right after that, right towards Florida as you go by the 26th, and curve some more and intensify. That's the latest on the GFS. So look at the ensembles for the GFS, agreeing that it more likely will form up, and it could go a little sooner and go right towards southern Florida. Still showing it'd be right on the edge of a hurricane. That's right on the 25th. If it does not take that path, it could be on the 26th, a little bit further up Florida. And if it don't take that path, it'll take more of a western track over here towards Mexico or southern Texas, all the way by the 29th. Latest update in the ensemble shows in 6 days where this system could possibly be at. And you can also see that it starts strengthening up, and it could be very fast. If it goes that quick, it would be very weak. We're talking a tropical depression, but shows still it could go over towards southern Florida. We can see this in many of the ensembles, even the control member agreeing with that, as we go literally 7 to 8 days away. Look how all these ensembles are agreeing. Sooner or later, it turns towards Florida. Now, we do have the later ones that shows maybe it can go to the west. It's not showing a big promise to that, but we are seeing it. Or even dancing right here on the eastern side of the Gulf of Mexico, get blocked by the high pressure and just sit there for a little bit, strengthen up, then head back. So we're seeing a lot of weirdness in the ensembles. So we have the trough moving down, pulling it to the north, northeast, northwest, in that direction. We also have the upper level high that is doing blocking and steering and is moving at the same time. So it makes it very difficult. The latest with the Canadian, it did not miss a hitch. It is the only one that is still showing. See, it goes towards the center of the Gulf of Mexico, becoming a hurricane. It's the only one that shows still it is going to go into that Gulf and not go on that far western push. But the latest shows it'll be a little bit further to the west, still a hurricane, but you see how it goes towards Louisiana, then turns at the last minute towards Alabama. So it's still showing somewhat in northeastern Gulf of Mexico and a strong tropical storm all the way to the northeast. So it's still showing it will impact multiple states. Now, the ensembles are agreement that it will favor the Western Caribbean and it could head north. Now, if it heads north and it goes very quickly, it could strengthen down to a hurricane still right over the Big Bend of Florida. And if it comes later, that's on the 25th. If it comes later, has another chance for the same area or start going west. So once it hits around the 26th, it's either going to be northern Gulf of Mexico or western Gulf of Mexico. You see that? That's on the 26th. And then we have what comes later, maybe the 27th or 28th. So if it's going towards Florida, it's going to make it within the first week to 8 days. If it's not going towards Florida and heads north or northwest, it will be landfall from the 26th on. Now, the latest from the Urals, taking away that strong left turn, still has a lot of land interaction, keeping it weak, but shows immediately that as that upper level high switches over towards the eastern side, it pulls this, your trough comes down, and it pulls it all together. Has it all into one. Has your trough coming down, creating a stronger storm. Has a blocking upper level high over here on the eastern side that's steering it to the west, northwest. And it strengthens up right before a landfall. Not showing it has a lot of time to strengthen is the good news out of that. But it could sit there after landfall for a few days. Showing it will roll around somewhat like the artificial intelligence was showing earlier. It'd be more on that west-northwest than a strong western push. And then go straight towards Texas and Louisiana. Now in this shot, we ran out of time, but it is showing a tropical storm. Not a hurricane or anything stronger. When you look at the Euro Ensemble control member, showing the same thing around the 27th, a little bit later, because earlier it would be eastern, and showing over Louisiana. At the same time, showing again a tropical storm. So it's either going to be a little bit northern, or it's going to be anywhere from the 26th to the 27th to the 28th, anywhere along the western Gulf states. If it does not take the 24th and 25th, maybe even the 26th, going towards Florida. That's the two different paths. And when you look at the ensembles of the Euro, you can see this is in agreement with the rest of them. It favors right here on the Western Caribbean, going towards the central Gulf of Mexico. At the same time, look, from that point, it's all widespread. It could go towards Florida, which is still showing a 972. That is trending. That is going to be a 972 by Big Bend on the 26th. That's trending on almost all the ensembles. Canadian takes it a little bit further to the west. If it's not going to be that one, it's going to be further to the north on the 27th, the 28th, or even the 29th or later. I'm showing there's a good chance that we're going to have another one in early October in the same area. Now, the last model I have you for the trend is the AI of the Ural. You can see it's showing it strengthening. Weakens down over to Yucatan, which is what you should see, and not strengthening like earlier going west. Land interaction would weaken it down, but still showing that west-northwest path. And as you go by the 26th, it misses chance to go towards Florida and goes straight towards Texas and Louisiana as a hurricane. Somewhere around the 27th, 28th. So earlier in the 20s, it's going towards Florida. That's the way the pattern is. If it's from the 26th on, it's going to go towards more towards the west, towards Alabama, Mississippi, the 26th, the 27th, towards Louisiana, maybe even towards Texas. But this definitely in the later 20s, we are definitely looking like the Western Gulf of Mexico. And that is staying strong all the way towards Ohio Valley and Great Lakes as a tropical storm affecting multiple states. We're seeing a lot of that also. This is going to impact multiple states, not just the Gulf states. It's going to be flooding and winds from a strong tropical storm going through our country. Matter of fact, the latest on our potential velocity anomaly shows that we are coming into a lot of favorable environment as we reach into the middle 20s all the way into the beginning of October. So it could be very strong formations in our Gulf, even a later formation in the very beginning or after a few days in the beginning of October. Again, in the Gulf of Mexico, while we're dealing with something possibly in the Atlantic and the MDR. Plus, I will update you on that severe weather for tomorrow. It is looking stronger for what we have going on for tomorrow. Showing chances for damage and winds. There's chances for tornadoes with that as well. And that looks like a strong system lining up. So I will keep you updated on that in the morning's video. Thank you for your time, everybody. I'll keep you updated. I appreciate every single one of y'all. Thank you for helping me get this information out to other people. Because remember, safety is the best thing we could practice. And that is by caring for others and helping others. Amen. God bless all of you. Hope you have a very great day today. Now, before I go, 1 Corinthians 8:1-9. Now, as touching things offered unto idols, we know that we all have knowledge. Knowledge puffeth up, but charity edifieth. And if any man think that he knoweth anything, he knoweth nothing yet as he ought to know. But if any man love God, the same is known of him. As concerning, therefore, the eating of those things that are offered in sacrifice unto idols, we know that an idol is nothing in the world, and that there is none other God but one. For though there be that are called gods, whether in heaven or in earth, as there be gods many and lords many, but to us there is but one God, the Father, of whom are all things, and we in him, and one Lord Jesus Christ, by whom are all things, and we by him. Howbeit, there is not in every man that knowledge. For some with conscience of the idol unto this hour eat it as a thing offered unto an idol, and their conscience being weak is defiled. But meat commendeth us not to God. For neither if we eat are we the better, neither if we eat not are we the worse. But take heed, lest by any means this liberty of yours become a stumbling block to them that are weak. Amen. Have a great evening, everybody. I'll see you first thing in the morning. Thank you all for your help and your support. I appreciate every single one of y'all. And remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and every single one that is around you and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great night, everybody. I'll see you in the morning. I got a feeling that we're going to see a better picture of what we can expect by tomorrow.